we keep falling in and out.
Subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt.
Subhanallah.
Our hearts are so quick to break. At this moment our souls are awake.
Forgive yourself and defy your heart disease. Care for others and give your spirit a release.
We keep falling in and out.
Subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to another episode of Moments for the Heart, and I'm your host, Omar Dunlab. In the past couple episodes, we've been talking about some of the specific diseases of the heart and their cures, as noticed by Muslim scholars, as mentioned in the Hadith, as mentioned in the Quran. We've dealt with miserliness and hatred and wantonness, which is like extravagance. And we've talked about some really amazing things, and we've talked about some of the great qualities of the heart in and of itself. When we say the heart, we mean the soul, but we also mean the heart, and there's some correlation between the two. And so, you know, exactly what it is, we're not exactly going to discuss because it's somewhat of a complicated topic. So for the sake of clarity, we're just saying the heart. And we're focusing on how to purify the heart, how to bring ourselves closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how to be great people, how to be humble people, how to be people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, and really to have beautiful souls. Because the Sahaba, they were very concerned with working on their souls. We forget that the first masjid in Islam was not the Masjid An-Nabawi, not this big masjid. It was a very small and humble structure. And it didn't bother the Sahaba, because they knew that if they could make dhikr, if they could make salah, you know, then they could work on beautifying their souls. They don't have to go to a beautiful building. But if they beautified their souls, that their outer surroundings would become beautiful as well. And there's actually a saying in English, we say, like begets like. In other words, as I am, so will my surroundings be. And this is one of the great mercies from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that if we're really merciful, if we're really humble, if we really have a good opinion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we really try to purge negative thoughts out of our minds, right, then we can have a great life. If we could be content with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we could be satisfied with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Lord, with Muhammad as Prophet, and with Islam as Deen, well then we have everything we need. You know, we're on the ship. You know, we're on the ship and we're just happy. Subhanallah. We're great people. And so that's what this show is focused on. It's focused on how to be better, how to better ourselves, how to better our environment, how to better our society, the world around us, and this sort of thing. And these are things that in these times are very important. The disease of the heart, which we will be talking about today, the spiritual disease of the heart, is the disease, in English we'll call it iniquity. In Arabic they call it baghi, which means desire. But desire in and of itself isn't always bad. We can desire something good. We can desire, for example, more knowledge about Islam. We can desire wealth in the sense that we want to give it to the poor or build a masjid. You know, so this type of desire is good, something every Muslim should have. We're not talking about that kind of desire. We're talking about the kind of desire that you desire something so much, typically like a worldly position, like you want to be a boss, you want to be the head man, you want to be the head honcho, you got to lead something, you feel the need to be a leader, to be known as the leader, you know. And that sort of desire motivates you to transgress the rights of people below you to get it. And so you could also say that it's the love of worldly position. And this is something that really as Muslims we have to be on guard about. We have to realize that, you know, this actually comes back to not being satisfied with qadr, not being content with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for us. You know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our Prophet Muhammad, he said that contentment is a treasure that is never exhausted. In other words, it doesn't run out. You can't, you know, lose contentment unless it's your own choice to do so. But if you decide to be content, if you decide today that Allah, I accept your decree, I accept where I am, and I know that it's for the best, and if you have that faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will never be exhausted. That's a treasure that is never going to wear out. But the problem is, sometimes we feel that, you know, Shaitan comes and he drops some little whisperings into our heart, you know, some of those little things that he says, and, you know, he says, well, you know, maybe you shouldn't trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much because he might put you somewhere you don't want to be. You know, what if he decrees for you to be a garbage collector while you have aspirations to do such and such and so and so? Well, you can respond to Shaitan by saying, I trust in my Lord. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that he loves those who trust in him. And that those who trust in Allah, then Allah is sufficient for them. What does that mean, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for them? It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to betray them. He's not going to put them somewhere that they can't handle. He's not going to put them somewhere that things aren't made easy for them. And as long as you trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you have that trust and that relaxation and your heart can find that stillness and that yaqeen, that certainty of belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is never, never, ever unjust to His creatures, then you'll be provided for. And this is what the Qur'an says. And we'll probably mention this Qur'an verse a lot as the series goes on, inshaAllah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the 65th surah of the Qur'an, the second and third ayah, He says that those who have taqallah, who fear Allah, right, then He will provide for them from sources from which they can never imagine. Right? So just trust in Allah, fear Allah, obey Allah, you'll be fine. It's the people who don't obey Allah, the people who don't work on purifying their heart, the people that you never see making dhikr, the misers of the world, these are the people that are miserable. We are Muslims. We have nur. We're mu'min. We have nur. We have light in our heart. And it is our duty to show that nur to the rest of the world. The rest of the world should envy us and want to emulate us, not us emulating them, not us begging for some table scraps from their table. We are the people of nur. We are the people of light. We are the people of guidance, right? And we should, our light should shine for the whole world to see. Subhanallah. We do not have to love worldly position. All we have to do is trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He is the most beautiful, the most wonderful creator. And He will put us exactly where we need to be. Just have faith in that. And if you find yourself somewhere you don't like to be there, just trust Allah. Just trust in Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will deliver me from this if I put my faith in you, if I worship you. Because you know, one of the Sahaba, he said, when adversity is at its worst, deliverance is near. Think about that. When adversity, when difficulty, when trials are the most worst, they're the heaviest, you feel like you can't take another step, that is when you should be the happiest. Because that's when the deliverance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when His rescue comes, and He provides from you from sources from which you could never imagine. So we don't have to, as Muslims, you know, we don't have to have iniquity. We don't have to transgress the rights of someone to get something from dunya and become this disgusting human being. We are people of nur, we are people of love, we are people of mercy, of compassion. Subhanallah, this is how we should view the deen. This is the example we should set for the rest of the world. This is our responsibility, which we've forgotten about. And we need to be reminded of it. We need to be reminded that we're Bani Adam. We imitate Adam, our father. We don't imitate anybody else. We don't seek anything from anybody else. We trust in Allah. We ask only of Allah. We only need from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's it. That's the bottom line. So just correct that perception if you have it. And if you find that you're being too hard with people, you know that's something you need to think about. Iniquity is not something, by the way, that just affects a king. You know, we think transgressing somebody's rights below us, this is what the leaders of the world today have. It's not only them. You know, a boss, a supervisor at Pizza Hut or McDonald's or something can have iniquity. He can be treating his subordinates very bad. He makes things very hard on them. He works them long hours. He doesn't pay them very well. You know, this is iniquity. You know, this is somebody whose heart has no mercy. And what did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say about the person whose heart has no mercy, who doesn't show mercy to others? He says they will not be shown mercy by Allah. And that can mean in this life or the next or both. The anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can encompass him in this life, at the moment of death, and in the akhirah. And that's something, really, it's something to be feared, and it's something that we should think about. And it doesn't always have to be just your boss or your manager. It doesn't even have to be somebody that has some dunya position. It could be somebody's father. You know, really today, some of the dads of today, some of the fathers of the world are hard on people. They're hard on their children. They're hard on their wife. You know, the dad is Fir'aun, right? The wife is Asiya, and the children are Bani Israel, right? And the children can't even throw rocks, you know? At least now, the people of Dawood alayhi salam, he could throw the rock at Shimshun, right? Now the children, they can't even throw rocks. They can't even say one word to their father, you know, because of how angry he will get or something. And he's transgressing people's rights because he thinks it will make him happy. And that's something we mentioned in a previous episode, and we'll probably mention it from time to time just to refresh your mind, that, you know, no one does evil for the sake of evil. No one's evil just because he woke up today and said, I want to be an evil person. People are evil because they mistake it for happiness. They think it will bring them some worldly benefit, you know. And this is really, we have to correct our perception of this, because true happiness is in knowing Allah. And this is what Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawzi said. This is what many great scholars have said. Any scholar worth his weight, he said this, that you, if you do not know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are not happy. You are not satisfied. You know, there's a void in you that can't be filled. It may not be there all the time, but it's there. And you will not get rid of it until you know how to do dhikr, until you know how to pray, until you know how to remember Allah Azza wa Jal, until you're close to Him, until you purify your heart. You will never be happy. You'll never be satisfied. And this disease of iniquity is something that's very complex. And so we will make this a two-part episode, inshallah. And the next episode, we will also be talking about iniquity. And inshallah ta'ala, I hope that we will be able to get into some of the cures and we'll be able to rectify that issue if some of you haven't. And I'm very glad that you could join us today for another episode of Moments of the Heart. And once again, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all among the believers whom He loves to meet and who loves to meet Him. And we hope to see you next time, inshallah ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We keep falling in and out,
subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt,
subhanallah.
Our hearts are so quick to break. At this moment our souls are awake.
Forgive yourself and defy your heart disease. Care for others and give your spirit a release.
We keep falling in and out,
subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt,
subhanallah.
The ultimate fact, if merely in you,
subhanallah.
That Allah's mercy ever look after you,
subhanallah.